A very good day to everyone. It is my pleasure to welcome to Lacombe's the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu, escorted by the Director of CCMB and Karthikeyan Vasudevan. We also extend a very warm welcome to Honorable Home Minister of Telangana, Sri Muhammad Mehmood Ali. I request everyone to please stand up and welcome the dignitaries with an ovation. Please remain standing for the national anthem. We will begin the program with the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya He Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindhu Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vandha Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Utchala Jalakita Ranga Tava Shubha Name Jage Tava Shubha शमागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जय गण मंगल गायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
We would now like to present a potted plant to the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu. We would also like to present a plant to the Honorable Home Minister of Telangana, Sri Muhammad Mehmood Ali. I now call upon the Director of CCMB, Dr. Vinay Nandikuri, to please welcome the Honorable Vice President of India.
It's okay. Honorable Vice President Venkaiah Naidu Gariki, Home Minister Muhammad Ali Gariki, Chief Wildlife Warden of Telangana, Madam Shobha Gariki, State Director of WWF, Madam Farida Gariki, CCMB scientist, staff, and student ki vala tarupuna nenu. I would like to invite you all. And the first time I recall seeing our Vice President, Honorable Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, was when I was 13 years old. My father is a bank manager, used to be a bank manager, and he was transferred to a place called Udaygiri. Udaygiri is the constituency of Honorable Vice President Venkaiah Naidu Garu in those days. And it so happened that he was visiting the bank or something like that, and I was 13 years old. I used to go to bank pretty regularly to see my father. And that's when I saw him, and it kind of etched in my memory because of his personality. He has this towering presence, which I can now directly see after all these years. And it's an honor to meet you, sir, after all these years. And I really would like to say that it's our privilege to have you here today at Lacombe's campus. And on behalf of all of CCMB, staff, students, we would like to wish you belated happy returns of the day for yesterday. So you heard already a lot about CCMB Lacombe's campus from Karthikeyan. And one thing that I would like to add, that our fourth director, Dr. Lalji Singh, is the one who established this campus. And he has done a terrific job of it. It's a beautiful campus, and I know I can see it every time. This is my second visit. I mean, it's an amazingly beautiful campus, and completely has wild look about it. CCMB has been doing a lot in terms of COVID pandemic, in terms of establishing diagnostics, in terms of teaching that to the other people so that they can learn the diagnostics. Lacombe's campus in itself is among the one of the initial centers to identify COVID infection among the animals, wild animals in the zoo. And so this in the recent past, along with the Central Zoo Authority, they have released guidelines with the pictorial guidelines, beautifully made, that could be used by zoos across India for collecting samples and how to process the samples for COVID infections. So I really do not want to say much more. I mean, you've seen the campus, it's a beautiful campus. And I just want to say that in addition to COVID research, CCMB and LACONS are involved in many other activities. We do structural biology, we do cell biology, and we do work on various aspects, including cancer to infectious disease biology, not simply COVID, but other things too. So on behalf of all of us, we would once again like to actually welcome you. And we are very happy that you are here with us today to visit this campus. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Nandikuri. Next, I request the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaya Naidu Garu, to release the book titled Introduction to Biobanking. For that, I request Dr. Vinay Nandikuri, the Honorable Home Minister of Telangana, Sri Muhammad Mehmood Ali, and Dr. Karthikeyan Vasudevan to please come upon the dais. I would like to state that this book is a joint effort by LACONS and the Central Zoo Authority to provide an overview of the technology for ex situ conservation of wildlife genetic resources. Thank you for the book release. And now it is my pleasure to call upon the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaya Naidu Garu, to address today's gathering.
Namaskar. Sri Mahmood Ali, Telangana Home Minister. Dr. Vinay Nandikuri, Director, CCMB, Dr. Karthikeyan Vasudevan, in charge of CCMB and this LACONS project, Srimati R. Sobha, Principal Chief Conservator of Forest, Telangana State, Dr. S. Kukreti, Additional Principal Chief Conservation of Forest and Director of Zoos and Parks, Telangana. And people who are working here, and my youngsters who are all part of the institute getting the knowledge training. I am really very happy and delighted to visit this institute, CCMB Laboratory for Conservation of Endangered Species, and also interact with all of you and acquaint myself with the excellent work being done in this lab. I always say I am on a knowledge pilgrimage. I go around the country after I became Vice President and then visit various universities and also institutes, research institutes, IITs, IIITs, IIMs. The other day, yesterday I was in Chennai, IIT, and also go around to various agriculture related research institutes, Krishi Vijnana Kendras, and also interact with scientists, by visiting laboratories like this. I had the occasion to visit CCMB. CCMB is one of our prestigious organization which is doing a great job and which is situated in Hyderabad. I had an opportunity to visit that institute twice. As a matter of fact, the idea of a vice president going around these institutions across the country, the idea is to acquire knowledge, enhance my own knowledge, and also acquaint myself with what is happening in various laboratories, what is being done, see the good work myself, appreciate the scientists, the research scholars, and the other youngsters who are all engaged in this research activity, and also to look beyond the ordinary and break new ground in their chosen fields. That is the objective of the youngsters who are working in this. So it is imperative to be innovative in the fast changing world ruled by technology and innovation. We are meeting under the shadow of a once in a century pandemic with COVID-19 wreaking havoc across the globe. Even the so-called developed countries, nobody is an exception. We are all seeing it. And also naturally we are worried. Because tens of thousands of lives have been lost while livelihoods are affected and economies have been hugely impacted. Our lifestyles have altered dramatically, and all of us, we are witnessing adapting to a new normal. This is also time for scientific institutions to rise to the occasion, intensify their efforts in finding ways to combat the pandemic and to meet the future threats, because this is not the end of the story. This is what is being said. We are now talking of a third wave, its effect. With the SARS-CoV-2 mutating frequently, we are seeing the emergence of a new variants that are causing faster transmissibility. This is a cause for concern and calls for stepped up efforts from scientists to neutralize its ability to spread rapidly. I think there is a need to fast track genome sequencing of the new variants to speed up development of suitable vaccines and drugs. Perhaps international collaboration by research institutions have to be intensified, and the feasibility of developing a universal vaccine that can neutralize various variants need to be studied. That seems to be the need of the hour. Specialized research focusing on sequencing would help in timely intervention during the ongoing pandemic. Sequencing as an adjunctive tool plays a critical role in identifying the emergence of new viral mutations and thus helps to combat the spread of COVID-19. The need for genome sequencing of new variants becomes crucial in the light of efforts of big cats contracting COVID-19 in a few zoos in the country. As you are all aware, species jump of virus from humans to animals and vice versa can lead to a new variants and pose fresh challenges in the ongoing fight against this pandemic. So the challenges posed by the pandemic has made several organizations to reorganize themselves and deliver in a timely manner. The scale of the impact demands extraordinary efforts to meet this extraordinary situation, and also efforts for strong collaborative arrangements between the institutions. These LACONS, CCMB, I feel is rightly positioned to make these linkages at both national and international levels to understand the emergence of infectious diseases and prevent such pandemics in future. I'm told that LACONS is one of the four centers in the country that can test animal samples for COVID-19 infection. I'm happy to note that it has recently released the guidelines in collaboration with the Central Zoo Authority and Ministry of Forestry, Environment and Climate Change for the zoo frontline workers on COVID-19 investigation for captive animals. I would also like to compliment the CCMB for its contribution to the cause of COVID-19 mitigation that includes the establishment of rapid diagnostic genome sequencing and surveillance. I'm happy to note that the scientists at CCMB have been closely monitoring the spread of coronavirus in India and its rapid evolutions. Research done at this CCMB has also shown the coronavirus spreads through air and it can be detected in sewage and wild animals. The easy transmission of this virus poses many challenges, and the way in which it might infect new hosts or other species will be an important area of research. This is where the CCMB can take a lead and shed some valuable light. I am told the idea to set up this LACONS, a unique facility, was mooted in early 1990s, when India did not have a lab to study the genetic variation and reproductive fitness for wildlife samples. Since its inception, this LACONS has developed several biotechnology tools and used them for wildlife conservation. The universal primer technology, which was explained to us, pioneered by this LACONS, has strengthened wildlife forensic in the country by providing a powerful tool to bring offenders to trial and deliver justice. This is a very major achievement that way. The technology enables identification of an animal just by its tissue samples. This has empowered the state forest departments to implement forest protection measures. The benefits of this technology have been extended to prevent illegal trade of wild animals, wild plants and their parts. I'm happy to note that this LACONS scientists using DNA from animals as the source of information have helped start tortoises to be repatriated back to their homes in Nalamala Hills, and they were rescued from the smugglers. It gladdens me to learn that the National Wildlife Genetic Resource Bank at LACONS is one among the exclusive league of 23 such labs in the world. I am told that the scientists at LACONS have developed technologies for assisted reproduction and have successfully reproduced black buck, spotted deer and rock pigeon using these advanced technologies. In Nehru Zoological Park, endangered mouse deer have been successfully raised from a few individuals to more than 250. These are all really major developments. The similar effort should be made for Angal deer in Kashmir, wild buffaloes in Chhattisgarh, and red ponds in Darjeeling. I am pleased to note that the activities of LACONS involving zoos have prompted the formation of a consortium involving five zoos from different parts of the country to promote biobanking of endangered species. This is a very timely initiative. I am sure this consortium and others will take full advantage of this biobanking facility. With the ongoing climate change has become real. Must have read in newspapers the climate change, how it is affecting in America and also Canada, how the temperature has gone up unusually. Even in India, we are also witnessing, and it also underlines the importance of the need for taking effective steps as climate change is real and it is happening. We, unfortunately, human beings, we all have played with the nature, destroyed some of the nature's gifts, for example, forests. Forests, I was discussing with the Honorable Home Minister, there were plenty of forests during my childhood even. Now we are planting trees. On one side we are cutting the trees, now we are planting also. There is every need to really plant trees in a massive manner and protect them. I'm happy that the Telangana Chief Minister is taking interest. Afforestation is needed of the hour. We must go out of the way to develop forests, greenery at every place, including place of our residence. We have some of the most biodiverse regions and is home to a wide range of ecosystems such as forests, grasslands, wetlands, deserts and coastal and marine ecosystems. We not only need to protect and preserve our ecosystems but also make every effort for conservation of endangered species for the well-being of animals, plants and humans. I have always been stressing the need to protect nature, preserve the culture for a better future. Nature, culture together for a better future. This is what I stress everywhere. I am sure that the modern biotechnological tools will help in mitigating the adverse effects of wildlife on wildlife and ecosystems. Before concluding, I would like to appeal to people to shed vaccine hesitancy. Some people think it vaccine is a government business. That is the business means work of government. Vaccination is for our protection. In fact, it should become a national movement and every person should get vaccinated, make their family vaccinated and also take initiative to educate the neighbors also, because it is the safest thing that has been proven. We are all seeing and we have reports that our vaccine, Covaxin, is useful even to tackle the new Delta variants and other things. That's a happy news to us. So our scientists, our doctors, they are really great. They are doing a great job. But we must take advantage of it and we must pass on the information to the people. Media, it should play very important role in this, and the icons of the society, various people, they should also get themselves involved into this movement of educating the people. The vaccines made by Indian companies are safe and are effective. At the same time, people should not lower their guard. Everyone should follow COVID-19 appropriate behavior by avoiding large gatherings, maintaining social distancing, wearing masks and remaining in well-ventilated areas. This is also equally important. Once COVID-19 is behind us, we would have also taught us, that has taught us the importance of being technologically ready to deal with other infectious diseases in our country. There are many reports that connect climate change to emerging infectious diseases. So I hope that CCMB and LACONS and other research institutes and public health organizations in India would expand their facilities to perform surveillance using rapid genome sequencing platforms. Undoubtedly, a strong focus should be one's health. This idea is already embodied in Maha Upanishad, such as Vasudhaika Kutumbakam. I urge our scientists to strive in making India self-reliant and a global leader in public health and in dealing with emerging health challenges in the future. ఈ రోజు ఇక్కడికి రావడం, మీరు చేస్తున్న పరిశోధనలను గమనించడం, స్వయంగా కళ్ళారా తిరకించడం, మీతో కాసేపు మాట్లాడడం, మీరు చేస్తున్న పురోగతిని గురించి, ప్రగతి గురించి తెలుసుకోవడం చాలా సంతోషంగా ఉంది. ఈ వాతావరణ పరిరక్షణ చాలా అవసరం. దాంతోపాటు వన సంరక్షణ, సస్య సంరక్షణ, పశు సంరక్షణ, జంతు సంరక్షణ, ఇవన్నీ మన సంరక్షణకు దారితీస్తాయి. అదేదో వాటి గురించి అని అనుకోవద్దు. ఇవన్నీ తగిన పాడలో ఉంటే ఒకటి మరొకదానికి సహాయకారిగా, పరోపకారిగా, ఉపకారిగా ఉండి సమతోలనాన్ని తీసుకొచ్చే ప్రయత్నం సమాజంలో చేస్తాయి. ఒకప్పుడు అలాగే చేసేవి. కానీ మనం మనుషులం, స్వార్థపరులమై అజ్ఞానులమై మనము ప్రకృతి ఆడుకున్నాం. ప్రకృతి ఇప్పుడు మనతో ఆడుకుంటుంది. ఈ క్లైమేట్ చేంజ్ అంటే అదే కదా, ప్రకృతి జనంతో ఆడు. సో మళ్ళా మనం వి మస్ట్ గో బ్యాక్ టు అవర్ ఓల్డ్ కల్చర్ ఆఫ్ లివింగ్ విత్ ద నేచర్, ప్రొటెక్టింగ్ ది నేచర్ సో దట్ వీ కెన్ లివ్ హ్యాపీలీ. ఈ విషయాన్ని అందరూ గమనించాల్సిన అవసరం చాలా ఉంది. ఇది ప్రభుత్వాల కార్యక్రమం, ఏ కామ్ హై తో సర్కార్ కా హై, ఏ సబ్ కామ్ సర్కార్ కరేగా, హమ్ బేకార్ బయటతో చెరేగా, ఐసా నై చెరేగా. దిస్ హ్యాస్ టు బి అండర్స్టూడ్ బై వన్ అండ్ ఆల్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీబడి. ఐ హోప్ విల్ పర్ఫార్మ్ దేర్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీస్. అవర్ ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ ఇస్ టేకింగ్ ఇనిషియేటివ్ టు క్రియేట్ రైట్ క్లైమేట్ ఇన్ ద కంట్రీ ఫర్ ఇన్నోవేషన్. యూఆర్ ఆల్ సీయింగ్ నా దీస్ వర్డ్స్ ఇన్నోవేషన్, ఇంక్యుబేషన్, ఇంటర్వెన్షన్, many of these things, they have become part of our activity now. They must be accelerated. Innovation for a better nation. So I hope that people here in this institute who are working the cones as well as zoo, they'll pay more and more attention to take steps to protect this endangered species and also protect the humanity in a big way. I would like to compliment all of you for the wonderful work that is being done. Thank you very much. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
Thank you. Thank you, Honorable Vice President of India, for your very kind words about our institution and for appreciating the work that we do not only in wildlife conservation, ecology and evolution, but also across the wider gamut of biological sciences, the work that goes on at CCMB. And we are fortunate indeed that your knowledge pilgrimage has brought you to our doors, and we hope to see you again. As a token of our appreciation and to mark this event, we would like to offer you a memento. I request our director, Dr. Vinay Nandikuri, to please do the needful. And now, I call upon my colleague, Dr. Karthikeyan Vasudevan, to offer a vote of thanks for the occasion on behalf of all of us from CCMB Lab.
Words of thanks, no vote.
So it has been a wonderful day. Our chief guest, Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaya Naidu Garu. So I thank you for your kind visit here, for obliging to come here within a very short notice, and making this visit as part of your journey, as you said, to visit different knowledge centers in the country. And we hope it will bring you back here someday in a place which has transformed and also taken your words of advice and implemented them. and you will see greater growth here, I hope, if you will visit next time. I again thank you, sir, for your kind visit here, and it has illuminated us tremendously. It has given us the motivation to go ahead and do many things in a very purposeful way. I also thank our guest of honor, Sri Mohammad Mehmood Ali Garu, State Home Minister, who has also kindly consented to kindly come over and preside over this occasion, and our director, Dr. Vinay Nandikuri. He has been a source of guidance for us, and he has supported all our activities continuously, and particularly for this visit, he has been providing us necessary advice from time to time. Our dignitaries, Srimati R. Sobha Garu, PCCF and Chief Wildlife Warden. Telangana Forest Department has been our constant source of support, sir. And particularly, Madam Sobha Garu, she has taken special interest in the activities that we do in association with the Nehru Zoological Parks and other places. So I thank her heartily for coming over and presiding in this occasion. And Ms. Farida Tampal from WWF India, State Director of AP and Telangana. And she has also been interacting with us continuously and supporting our work. And our mutual interests also keep guiding us to do better service to the country. The Central Zoo Authority is not represented here, sir, but Dr. Sonali Ghosh, Dr. S.P. Yadav, both of them have been a great source of support for LACONS, and they have been responsible for the booklet that you have kindly released today. This would not have been possible with the generous support we have been receiving from the central government through CZA. And for organizing this event, I would like to thank the Telangana State Police, who have taken special interest in making all the necessary arrangements, helping us at every step to make sure that this event goes smoothly. The GHMC officials who have come and helped us in organizing this event. The CCMB team, I would like to take a few names. Dr. Lakshmi, who's my colleague and has been a constant source of support. She has been guiding us from every step to be able to make this arrangement and conduct this smoothly. The staff members, my faculty colleagues, students, they have been tirelessly working to make these arrangements. The security staff, security officer, security staff of LACONS and CCMB. Dr. Somdatta, whom I would like to acknowledge for having contributed to preparation of this booklet. And she has also contributed to the preparation of the guidelines for COVID COVID precautions that need to be taken. So with this, I would like to end my word of thanks.
We are nearly at the end of the events for the day. Before we disperse, I request the audience to please stand up and join in the national anthem.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंधु गुजरात मराठा द्रविड़ उत्कल बंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्छल जल के तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ समागे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
And with that, we come to the end of today's program. I reiterate that it has been our honor and pleasure to have the Honorable Vice President of India, Sri Venkaiah Naidu Garu, to visit our institution. We sincerely hope for a bright future for the science and practice of ecology and conservation in India. Jai Hind.